Okay.
Yes.
Up to now we have discussed about GPS receiver and its block diagram. Before that we have discussed about how satellites will be in the space, and we have talked about 24 satellites will be there, and there will be 6 paths. Each path or each constellation consists of 4 satellites. Okay, that satellites will downlink the signal. Our GPS receiver will receive the signal. As I said, GPS receiver does not require any data connection to detect the precise location, but to track the any vehicle or to detect the signal on a particular map. For example, I have a device which have been roamed yesterday all over the Hyderabad, and it has roamed about 10 kilometers. I want that particular path. So how to represent that particular GPS device roamed path on a particular Google map? So I am discussing about real-time GPS data on Google Maps. Okay, so for that what we require? We require a GPS device equipped in a vehicle. So vehicle has been equipped with the GPS device. As I say, so GPS device does not require any data connection, but to store the data and to send that particular data to the server for mapping purpose, or to locate or to track where GPS device has been roamed yesterday or in the past. So we required memory for the GPS device and a GSM connection to send the latitude and longitude and time values to the server. So our GPS device, which have been equipped in the vehicle, will store the latitude and longitude and time values for every 10 seconds. Let us say for every 10 seconds. It will store the latitude and longitude and time values, or we can also take speed and height from the mean sea level. So these 5 things it will store in the local database, in the memory. So for every 10 seconds it will store the latitude longitude values. So let us take 17.02 and 72.19, and time it is about 00. Let us take 10 o'clock and speed 60 kilometers and height 540. So again after 10 seconds again it will detect latitude longitude values, and again with 65 kilometers, again 570. So for every 10 seconds our using GSM, using the SMS or to particular server, to particular server using particular API, using particular API, that is lat value, long value and time value and speed value. So in this particular server it will send the data. Okay, our GPS device will send the data to the server. So let us discuss about server side. What happens at server side? So there is a GPS device here which is sending the data. So it is inserting in the database. So it should be inserted in the database. It should be inserted in the database. So before inserting the database, this GPS server will call a API, application programmable interface. So for every 10 seconds, using this API, that is 192.168.250/insert, insert particular lat value and long value and height value and latitude, longitude, height and time. So it will call this particular API and it will call our web service. It will call our web service, that is web server. So whenever this GPS device will insert the data in particular place and it will send to web server using the API, and this API server will insert into particular database. So in the this database can be anything, or SQL or MySQL or any server. So in this again we have database. Let us take a database, a DB, that is vehicle underscore insert, we have a DB. So in this again we have two tables, that is T underscore latest data and T underscore history. T underscore history. So at any time when we call this API, it will insert the latitude longitude values in the T underscore latest data. So this table structure would be like this: serial number 1, latitude value, longitude value, speed, height, speed, height and time. So here we are taking only single GPS server. So at any point of time in the latest data, we will have latest longitude, latitude value, and the time 10 o'clock. Okay, whenever this GPS receiver again calling this API and sending the latest data, again this web server will insert the into DB. So in the database again we have vehicle underscore insert database. Here table is T underscore latest data. So it should be overwrite this information. So again if it is sending it 10 o'clock, 10 minutes, 10 seconds, so again it should overwrite this particular data. But before overwriting this particular data, we are moving this into history using the time. So at 10 o'clock where it was, so we are moving into history table. Again we are inserting the new data. So this is at server side configuration. This is at server side configuration. Again when we want to track the data, so let us take, we have a Google Maps here. We have Google Maps here. So we want to track the live location. So using Google API services, using Google API services, we will send the latitude, longitude and the time to Google API services, API, geo, location service. So we can track
particular, let us say it is a road. So every time, for every 10 seconds, we can refresh the data and we can see that particular GPS device is tiring. So this is about live tracking of vehicle using the T_latest data table. Again, if you want to track the whole day, means not live location but exact at particular time, so we can pass the all the data from 10 o'clock to from 11 o'clock to the Google. If you want to track the whole yesterday information, then we can take the data from the T_latest street table where we are saving the all the data, and we can send that particular history data to the Google Maps and we can track the data, pass it somewhere. So if we want to plot all the data in the past, so we can take the data from the T_latest history table, we can pass the latitude, longitude, speed or time to the Google API services, and we can plot the all the path on the Google Maps using the T_latest table. Once again I am repeating, our GPS device will send the data of latitude, longitude, speed, height, time to the our web server API. Our web server API will insert particular values in the database. So in the database we have T_latest data and we have T_history data. In the T_latest data, at any time only particular live location values will be saved. So using this table we can plot the live location of particular device using the Google API services. Again, if you want to plot the all the past data, whenever we are inserting the new data, we are moving this data to the T_history table. Again we are inserting new values into the T_latest data. So using the T_latest data, we can find the live location of particular vehicle, and using the T_history data, we can find out the all the path where GPS device has been traveled using the T_history table. So in this way, if we equip the GPS device in the vehicle, we can make that GPS device to store the data, or we can make that GPS device using the GSM module. We can send particular latitude, longitude values to the web server. Our web server will insert the data into the database server. Our database server will save the all the history using the time and latitude, longitude values. So if you want to plot that particular points on the Google Maps, we can use the T_latest data. Using the T_latest data, we can find out the live location on the Google Maps using the Google API services. So if you want to plot the all the travel path of GPS receiver, we can use the T_history table, and we can pass the latitude, longitude and time values to the Google API services. Then it will plot us the all the path where GPS device has been traveled. Okay, thank you.